My name is Robert Fierret. I'm the master artisan of dry stone masonry, born in south of France in Saint-Chinian. I learned the traditional technique of dry stone masonry from my father and continued his enterprise, which he created in 1952. The technique of dry stone masonry includes skillful dressing and laying of the stones in such a way that it holds together all of them and forms an interlocked mass. We start laying the facing stones, which form the exterior layer, and the stones between the exterior layer are laid properly using very small and medium-sized stones in a way to minimize as much void as possible. There is no doubt that the dry stone masonry structures look exceptionally beautiful. Along with the unique aesthetic values, it has several other benefits. It facilitates the natural flow of air and water through the masonry structure and also has thermally insulating properties depending on the nature of the stones used. While laying the stones in their natural form, you have to change its orientation until you find its perfect placement. On-site training has become a big part of my profession, where I get a chance to train the new generation through the association called Compagnons du Devoir. The companions are the young students who are trained with the almost dying traditional building skills and knowledge in France. I feel extremely lucky that I met people who believed in me and supported me to revive the traditional technique by establishing an organization to initiate works in this domain. And it's a great pleasure to see how the young companions are mastering the skills while working together. The traditional skills of dry stone masonry is found all over the world. Recently, I got an invitation to give a training for the restoration of a temple in Lachen, North Sikkim in India. So I'm proud to say that the training is going international. For this restoration project, I got the opportunity to take two of my young companions trained in France to assist me. Their two young locals will also be trained during the restoration project. Here, you realize that it's more of a necessity rather than a trend. I think it's very important for the trainer as well as the trainee to love what they are doing and understand that they can create exceptionally beautiful structures with the traditional skills of dry stone masonry.